The first two-row seed drill was constructed already at the beginning of the 18th century. Later, its design has been improved throughout the centuries. How does the seed drill look today, and how is it manufactured? To discover this, we visit Agromash, one of the leading manufacturers of agricultural machines in Poland. Ready? Let's go! Everything begins at the design department, where several models are designed each year. Furthermore, improvements are introduced in already manufactured machines. When the design is ready, the production can start. So, it is time to cut metal sheets. They are collected from the automated warehouse and delivered to the laser cutting station. This way, all flat components of seed drills are made, including coulter discs or parts of main frame. Some sheets, e.g. box components, are embossed to reinforce its structure. Then the cut elements are transported to press brakes. Meanwhile, CNC processing centers are started in the machine hall. Steel bars and other components are collected from the warehouse and cut. And then transported for further processing. Here, seed drill hubs are manufactured. The first spindle turns the shape, and the second drills and threads holes. Here we can see processing of a coulter, a component responsible for forming a sufficiently deep furrow during sawing. Its surface is milled, and holes for fixing screws are drilled and threaded. The disc is its most important part, and here its axles are manufactured by two drills working simultaneously. A tube through which seeds are delivered to the ground is bent on a bending machine, while a coulter gauge wheel is manufactured on an injection machine. It will cover the seeds and compact the soil. And this huge machine is a bridge milling machine manufacturing, e.g. tools for other machines required in the production process. Meanwhile, at the steel profiles department, the seed drill components are cut out with a laser and then transported for welding. This process is mainly used to manufacture the frame, but we can also see here the cover of a seed box. Automatic welding machines weld the coulters. Now it's time for discs, which are transported for heat processing. A robot places them in a sharpening machine and then transports them to the furnace. Here, the component is tempered at 900 degrees Celsius. Afterwards, it is put in a press where it takes its final shape. Other parts that will work in soil are also sufficiently reinforced. Oil tempering and carburizing processes are conducted in special furnaces. Agromash is one of just a few manufacturers in Europe using carburizing. Then, washed and cleaned, components are transferred to the laboratory for the hardness test. After shot blasting of larger components and chemical washing of smaller ones, their surface is prepared for powder coating. It is not only an issue of appearance, but also of anti-corrosion protection. In Agromash, machines are usually painted in two colors, red and green. Thus, prepared parts are delivered for assembling. Components ordered from external suppliers, including electronic parts and drives, are collected from the high storage warehouse. Now the entire machine can be assembled. First, the seed box is installed. Then successive elements are added, like pressure controlling beams, drives of sewing distributors, a hydraulic system, and lighting are connected. Finally, the coulters of a shoe or a disc type are installed. Everything depends on the seed drill type, because the plant manufacturers seed drills not only for cereals, but also for rape and maize. In total, about 6,000 machines are manufactured at the Agromash factory every year.